Hey everybody, coming to you from our backyard here. And Jordan and I have been so busy filming other cars, like at, you know, the dealerships, like Fastlane and Gateway and stuff, that we haven't even been running our cars at all. And they've just been sitting around collecting dust in the shed, and it's really was getting pretty sad. So today it was nice out, and Jordan actually said, "Hey, why don't we go out and work on the Studebaker? Because you know it's getting pretty ridiculous." So that's what we did. In fact, when we pulled these out today, it was almost like finding a couple of barn finds. I mean, it was, they were pretty filthy, that's for sure. And I'm sorry about the gunshots in the background. My neighbor's just blasting the heck out of some steel targets over there, I think. So we'll do the best we can here. For today, we've got the 56 Studebaker Skyhawk out here and our 48 Ford F1. The one that's missing is the 47 Ford Super Deluxe, and that's because we haven't had a chance to clean it up yet, so that's on the agenda for tomorrow. But for those of you that are new to my channel, I thought we'd pull these out and at least take a quick look at them. And for you guys that are into Studebakers, you're probably like, "Oh, that doesn't look like a 56 Studebaker," but that's because it has a 53 front clip, 55 taillights, and some other little custom touches. So it is a hot rod, and it's been altered quite a bit. And we're not gonna do like a full-on walk around, but we'll just real quickly take a peek at these. A few little things. It's got the tri-bar headlights, like you'll find on like some Porsches and that kind of thing. And the blinkers are actually built into the headlight, which is kind of cool. Keeps everything looking nice and clean. And the car is just painted in a black epoxy primer, but it's been painted that way for years. And that black epoxy holds up really well. It doesn't chalk up like regular primer. And it's been pretty durable, honestly. And if you scratch it, it's easy to kind of fix it up and make it look good again. So maybe someday it'll get actually painted, but we're just gonna let it go for now. It is riding on some billet wheels. Those are Colorado Customs wheels. And it's wrapped in Michelin Pilot Sport tires, the same kind that you get on a 911 Porsche. And they're ZR rated to like 186 miles per hour, so which is sufficient. It's not chopped or anything. That is the factory roof line, but these cars are pretty aerodynamic, you know, right from the factory. Inside, pretty stock. As you can see, it's all black vinyl interior. It's just got a split back bench seat in there, and that's all original, not restored in any way. We have added some Pioneer speakers to the back deck there, just so we can at least hear the stereo. And I've got a few things kind of torn apart in here because we've been working on some stuff. It's like the console down there, that center dash piece is pulled out because I'm working on some wiring and different things. But we're gonna get it all squared away, and at least it's running really nice, and that's the main thing. Got a little bit bigger set of wheels out back, but from the same company, obviously, and everything. But you know, after we cleaned it up today, I mean, it's still looking pretty good. On the back here, these Studebakers actually had bolt-on fenders, so if you look at any of the stock ones, you'll see a chrome trim piece across the top of this, and that hides actually where the seam is. This car, we've actually, the metal's been peaked, you know, together, welded up and everything, so it's all one solid piece and there's no chrome trim. Just gives it kind of a smooth look. And personally, I really like these little coves they have on here, kind of like the Corvettes had in the 50s too. Just kind of cool little body line there. Yeah, like I said, it's not perfect. You know, it's got some chips and dings and whatever here and there. But overall, not a bad car. Here, let me pop the hood and I'll show you under there. Now, again, this thing is not very cleaned up right now. We just kind of did a once over, so it's not all fancy. All right, as you can see under the hood here, we have a 350 LT1. This is the aluminum head LT1. And it's got some street and performance goodies on there. You can see their tag right there. Obviously, you know, all fuel injected and everything. It's got some nice bracketry on it. Billet brackets, billet pulleys. You know, I'm really happy with how it's all set up. But I really have to get under here with some billet polish and get it all shined up, that's for sure. It's looking pretty bad at the moment. And the valve covers are custom. As you can see, they'll say Studebaker on them. One thing I don't like is we're still running the exhaust manifolds. I'd like to have a set of headers on here, but as you can see by that steering shaft there, it's a pretty tight fit in here. So it'll have to be, you know, a custom set of headers for sure. But, you know, we've got the exhaust manifolds to dual exhaust, there's no cats, and then there's Flowmaster muffler, so they flow really well, and it's tuned up nicely, and it runs strong, that's for sure. And this car is really light, so it still moves out pretty decent. Up here we have a custom B-Cool radiator. We had to have that custom built to fit because this low hood line doesn't give a lot of extra room. That's a nice aluminum radiator, and that's what they call a sprint car style filler neck. A little different. It just gave us a little extra hood room there. You want to go ahead and fire it up, and I'll show them that it actually still runs. It's just got two dumps there by the rear axle. It's got a 9-inch forward rear end. But go ahead and blip the gas just a little bit. That's good. You can go ahead and shut it off. But anyway, guys, as you can see, that one's still running. And we took it for a nice little cruise today. It's running out really well, actually. One thing, though, I had it basically empty of gas, so we put all new fresh gas in it, and it just ran out really well. Not a single stumble, so we were real happy about that. And the truck, it sat for a long time as well. And real quickly, if you're not familiar with this one, it's a 48 Ford F1, but it's sitting on a 1977 Ford chassis. There's a combination of F-150 and F-250 parts under here, depending on, you know, what worked the best. It's got a reverse cut Dana 44 front end, and then it has a 9-inch Ford rear end. You can see it has Rancho stabilizer shock there on the steering, and it has Rancho shocks all the way around. Nice big old, you know, coils for the lift and everything. And man, this thing is definitely heavily built. It's got a big old F-250 steering box, which works amazingly well. And then, as you can see, the frame, it's kind of weird how this is built. There's actually a full truck frame there, and then another frame stacked on top of it and all welded up. And that's where it got a lot of the height from there.
One of the cool things is that he said the steering box works great. This actually has a better turning radius than the Studebaker or my Trans Am.
It does. This thing, at full lock, it will tuck those tires all the way up in there, and you'd be amazed how, you know, quick this thing can turn. One of the reasons is that frame was actually chopped down, shortened, and put back together, so it's a pretty short wheelbase, and just the way it sits up, and then with that steering box, it really handles awesome. We won't spend too much time on here, but there's the 9-inch rear, and if you look, you'll notice it actually has disc brakes out back as well. Those are actually the front discs, but we adapted them to the back as well, so they're all the same size all the way around. And it stops really well, you know, considering how big it is and everything. But it is basically just a mud truck, so there's nothing fancy. Probably looks better in video than it really does. You know, it's a little rumpled up here and there. I just put on some of these kind of generic tail lamps, but they work, and I like these. I just kind of fabbed up some backup lights so it'd all be legal and everything. It is fully road legal, or at least we drive it on the road. So
they say if you can put a soda can
outside
out
the fender,
on the tire, and yeah, it passes your fender, it's illegal. But
so technically, it's maybe not legal. But I think
that
even
only
the
classifies the trucks that were built from a certain era.
And honestly, I think even the police think the thing's kind of cool, so they don't really give us any hassle, and we're not out doing stupid stuff with it. So go ahead and fire it up, I guess. It's not firing up like as quick as it did before, just because it's been sitting for so long, but hopefully it fires up good for us. Alright guys, in the spirit of honesty and fairness here, I thought I'd let you know that when we went to start the truck for the video, it wouldn't fire up. It actually just barely cranked over, so it probably has been sitting a little bit too long, because this thing has a starter with like 160 pound-feet of torque, but it still wouldn't crank over because that battery was weak. So anyway, I got the Lincoln. And we got it jumped, as you can hear, it's running. We'll go ahead and we'll have you rev it up here in a second so they can just hear it at least, you know. This thing has dual 3-inch pipes, if you can see that. But go ahead and rev it a little. As you can hear, it sounds pretty decent. But anyway, I'm sure it'll be fine now once we get it running, you know.
I think the problem was I said, oh, it always starts when I do it, and
yeah,
it didn't start.
No, it didn't want to.
I'm not even going to shut it off.
Yeah. Nah, we'll take it for a little spin and get it charged up.
But anyway, guys, this is just a quick video. Well, quick video, it's probably 10 minutes long. But I just wanted to get them out and just show you that they are still around and they're still running and everything. Like I said, tomorrow I'm gonna work on the red car, see if I can get it cleaned up and fired up and everything. But I thought I'd just give you a little update. So thanks for watching and commenting and everything. And we'll see you later. Bye.